Australians, oh, let us rejoice, for we are young and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
Professor David Lloyd, Vice Chancellor and President, Professor Gerald Goodhart, occasional speaker, members of council, doctors, emeritus professors, fellows, and senior management and staff of the university, graduands, ladies and gentlemen. As Deputy Chancellor of the University of South Australia, I'm delighted to welcome you to this graduation ceremony. At the outset, I acknowledge that this ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna people have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. As I stand on this stage and look out on a sea of faces, I feel extremely fortunate to be part of this university and honoured to play some small part in formally starting the next chapter of your lives. Outside the auditorium this morning and in here as you patiently waited for the official party, the excitement and sense of anticipation was palpable. But just as evident and significant was the sense of camaraderie and shared achievement. Whatever degree you have studied, whatever career you are planning, and however keen you are to start the next phase of your life, please take a moment today to look back and congratulate yourselves on a job well done. All those long hours and late nights were worth it. All of us on the stage today and all the university people who have worked with you during your studies share your pride and joy, as of course do your families and friends. I hope that we have served you well as an institution and that you find this ceremony a fitting acknowledgement of your time as a University of South Australia student. And I say farewell to you all because while you're all leaving the University of South Australia, most of you are also leaving the country and taking your new knowledge with you. In building your knowledge and skills, it is our goal as a university to equip our graduates to make a real and enduring contribution to society. And I wish you all the very best in your future endeavours. I know that in whatever field of expertise, you'll make a valuable contribution and lasting contribution to your own communities and take your part in a rapidly growing network of UniSA inspired success stories who are all doing interesting and good work throughout the world. I'm certain one of the keys to your success has been the love, support and encouragement of those closest to you, your family and your friends. I'm sure you're all aware, as am I, that without this support, you would not be here today. So to demonstrate your appreciation and to thank your family and friends for their invaluable contribution, I ask you to stand up and face your loved ones and give them a big clap and a cheer. Thank you, graduands. It is now my great pleasure to ask our Vice-Chancellor and President, Professor David Lloyd, to address you.
Nakanirna miarna, na mari na nari David. Na yartu yunku yaku, na kundurinti takindi naichu warli, na puntli naicha, na wagandi wara garna miarna, mi puntli naichu kunyantapadi. You don't often hear the first language of the original peoples of the Garna Plains spoken with an Irish accent. But what I said was, ladies and gentlemen, hello, my name is David. I'm not originally from this country, but I am very proud to call it my home. And I'm telling you this in the language of the Garna people as a mark of my respect. Good morning. Let me begin by congratulating you, our graduands. After years of hard work and study and exams and squatting, you finally made it. You've earned your degrees, and you're now about to go into the world on new journeys of discovery. As of today, you become members of a different society, an internationally educated, globally capable society. The degree that you've worked so very hard to secure wasn't developed by us to make a framed statement on an office wall, or on your parents' living room wall, or on your LinkedIn profile. The degree that you selected and earned is purpose-designed so that you can go on to make a difference. A difference to your family, to your neighbourhood, to your country, and to the world beyond. You've been educated and prepared to be leaders. True leadership has nothing to do with creating dynasties or exercising power over other people. True leaders are generally more focused on providing spaces for other people to occupy. It's got to do with giving power to other people so that they can go on to make the changes that are needed. Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu said that when the best leader's work is done, the people say, we did it ourselves. You've been educated and prepared for careers that can and will take you everywhere. As you take your place in this sometimes turbulent world, I ask that you maintain your international focus and plan on being citizens of the world. And when you do, you'll set an example for those who come after you. Take opportunities as they're presented. Fulfill the potential that we know is inside you. It's traditional now for me to reference an Irish literary great in my speeches. So today's winner is Jonathan Swift, the 17th century poet who was born in Dublin and wrote Gulliver's Travels. He said that vision is the art of seeing what's invisible to others. We've seen what's inside you, and we're very proud to have played our part in helping you develop into the fine people you've become. I'd like you all to know that as you leave here today, you carry with you a priceless gift. That gift is your education, and that education will prepare you to play a key role in 21st century society and the workforce. There have never been more options or more means through which you can achieve your goals and make a real and lasting contribution to the world. Think about our technologically connected society. There are well over 1.5 billion active users of Facebook, 330 million people tweeting away on Twitter. YouTube gets 4 billion views a day. And yet there are still 3 billion people in the world who live on less than $2.50 a day. 1.5 billion live on less than $1.25. That's in extreme poverty. Hunger is the world's number one cause of death. It still kills more people than HIV, AIDS, malaria, and tuberculosis combined. 1 billion people cannot read, and a lot more than you'd like to think live here in Australia. Hunger and poverty are old problems, and their impact on democracy is alarming. But hunger and poverty can be solved. We need new thinking, and creativity, and the will to do something about it. And that's where your leadership skills become very important. You can do something about this and convince others to join you. There's enough food in the world to feed everyone. No special scientific breakthroughs are needed. The United Nations estimate it would take $58 billion annually to offer basic education, clean water and sanitation, reproductive health, basic health and nutrition to every person in every developing country. It would take just $30 billion annually to eradicate world hunger. Compare this to a US defense budget that runs at $750 billion a year. What's needed in the world are people like you, leaders like you, to want to go on to challenge the status quo and to be part of the new thinking that gives us new ways to make change happen. Leadership and creativity combined with knowledge and political will are the ingredients that will help us solve these types of problems. Our challenge is to provide new creative solutions. To do that, I urge you to open your minds to new ideas, new opportunities, and new ways of thinking. No one expects you to go out and solve all the world's problems, but you can start on a small scale. Use your talents and your energy to fix the things that you see that cause difficulties and concern to those around you. I do hope that during your time at the University of South Australia, we've helped focus your energy, build your resilience, and polish your values until they shine. You leave here today with your graduate qualities fully intact. You all remember, of course, that while you were studying, that every program in the university has graduate qualities embedded in it. They're the qualities that we've put into our degrees since we first became a university in 1991. We were the very first Australian university to do this as a measurable part of your degree. Because it's our mission to make sure that you take your place in the world ready and able to act. So let me remind you, in case of the excitement of today, you've forgotten what your qualities are. As a graduate of the University of South Australia, you understand your subject area. You're ready to begin professional practice. You're prepared for lifelong learning. You're effective problem solvers. You can work autonomously and collectively. You're committed to ethical action and social responsibility. You can communicate effectively. You can demonstrate international perspectives as a professional and as citizens. That's what you're bringing with you into the wider world of opportunity. As you do that, I ask that you be good people, that you be authentic, that you take responsibility and be bold and courageous and embrace change. Now, besides celebrating your success as new graduates of UniSA today, we're also celebrating the evolution of our relationship. Whereas before you were students, now you become our graduates and very much more our partners. You are our advisors, collaborators, our supporters, and our friends. So stay in touch with us and think about how your contribution can help those who come after you. Excuse me. As new global citizens, you can continue to work with your university to shape the way and address the challenges of the future. You can partner with us in the evolution of your university. And if you can understand me, you'd be doing very well. This is part of the test. I'm so pleased that we streamed this live on the internet. We have bold and ambitious plans for the future, and I hope that you keep in touch with the institution that would surprise you with its innovation into the future. I have developed a new tone in my voice today. Next year, the University of South Australia celebrates its 25th birthday, and despite its short history, we're already considered to be one of the world's top universities, one that provides exceptional outcomes to its graduates. And put simply, that means we've given you the tools you need to succeed in your lives. Now it's up to you. Go out and make a real mark in your own world. But come back from time to time to tell us about it. Come back next year and help us celebrate our 25th birthday. Come back and do an advanced degree and take a seat on this side of the stage. You may have heard last week that UniSA is now considered one of Australia's top universities for research. So help us to come back and help us to add to that body of knowledge we're building. You're part of the UniSA commitment to success, a community that we celebrate, and I hope that you continue to be part of the life of the university we share. Lastly, as you embark on this next stage of your journey, remember you're not alone. You have hundreds of fellow members of this new society sitting in the room with you here this morning. It's a ready-made network of friends and colleagues who will form the nucleus of your new internationally connected lives. Stay in touch with one another through the alumni network, because that will help us to stay in touch with you. We want to celebrate your future successes every bit as much as we celebrate your success here today. So as you leave us to begin exploring your future, remember that your degrees are passports to new worlds of opportunity. Take those opportunities whenever they arise and enjoy the journey. It starts with you crossing the stage. If you're crossing the stage in brand new shoes, take your time. I will end as I began with my congratulations. I wish you every success, every joy, and great fortune for the future. And remember, we're all very proud of you. Well done.
Thank you very much, Vice-Chancellor. I now invite Professor Murray Wilson, Pro-Vice-Chancellor of Business and Law, UniSA Business School, to present Professor Gerald Goodhart for the honorary degree of Doctor of the University.
Deputy Chancellor, the University of South Australia awards the honorary degree of Doctor of the University to a person of eminence who has made a distinguished contribution to public service or a field of academic endeavor or artistic pursuit. It is my great pleasure to present Professor Gerald Joseph Goodhart for the honorary degree of Doctor of the University. in recognition of his distinguished service to the community. Professor Goodhart worked as a statistician, researcher, and business director from 1954 to 1974. During this period, he published three groundbreaking papers in Nature that documented law-like patterns and statistical distributions in consumers' brand switching and television viewing. He began his academic career in 1975, and in 1981 was named as the Sir John Cohen Tesco Professor of Consumer Studies at the prestigious Cass Business School at City University London, a chair he held until 1995 before his formal retirement. During this time, he served a successful tenure as Dean of the Business School. Professor Goodhart's book, The Television Audience, Patterns of Viewing, published in 1975 with an updated edition in 1987, remains the seminal research book on the subject, and it's still relevant in spite of the great technological and social change over the past decades. He collaborated with the Ehrenberg Bass Institute's namesake, Professor Andrew Ehrenberg, on a number of publications in the Journal of Marketing, Management Science, and the Journal of the Royal Statistical Society. He successfully supervised 9 PhDs and 3 MPhils without ever taking the time himself to do a PhD. His students are now leading professors at universities across the world. During his career, he served on several boards to serve the broader community in London. In 1967, and again in 1996, he was awarded the Market Research Society Medal for service to the profession. In 2003, he was the keynote speaker at the Australian Market Research Society annual conference in Melbourne. Professor Goodhart has dedicated his time to mentoring academics globally, including adjunct and emeritus positions at 4 universities. In particular, he was tirelessly dedicated to the fledgling Marketing Science Center at the University of South Australia that grew into the Ehrenberg Bass Institute for Marketing Science. His guidance helped the center eventually attain institute status in 2005, and his support has never waned. From 2006 to 2014, Professor Goodhart took a more formal service role as foundation chairman at different times of the Institute's Australasian, European, and North American advisory boards. He has been instrumental in the Institute's growth through his leadership in these meetings. He was a skilled chair who carried the necessary gravitas from his academic discoveries and industry influence to chair a board consisting of high-caliber marketing executives from leading global brands such as Mars, Unilever, and Procter & Gamble, as well as eminent professors from schools such as Harvard, the London Business School, and Wharton, as they work together to support the development of the now-renowned Ehrenberg Bass Institute. Gerald Goodhart is an outstanding scientist. Throughout his career, he has championed scientific values, and in this respect, has made a significant and lasting contribution to marketing research. He has made landmark marketing science discoveries with publications in Nature, the Journal of Marketing, the Journal of the Royal Statistical Society, the Journal of Marketing Research, the Journal of the American Statistical Association, and Applied Statistics and Management Science. To honor his legacy, the Ehrenberg Bass Institute will endow a scholarship fund, the Gerald Goodhart Postdoctoral Fellowship, to retain our best PhD students and further develop their talents and skills. Deputy Chancellor, on behalf of the University of South Australia, I am pleased to present Professor Gerald Joseph Goodhart for the honorary degree of Doctor of the University in recognition of his distinguished service to the community.
Thank you, Professor Wilson. On behalf of the University of South Australia, I confer on you, Gerald Joseph Goodhart, the honorary degree of Doctor of the University.
It is now my great pleasure to invite Professor Gerald Goodhart, Marketing Scientist, Emeritus Professor at London City University and Adjunct Professor at the University of South Australia, to deliver today's occasional address. And after the introduction that you heard of his achievements, I'm sure it'll be a fascinating insight. Thank you.
Deputy Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, distinguished guests, fellow graduands, our families and friends, ladies and gentlemen. I have a number of very pleasurable duties to perform in this speech. So let me begin, Deputy Chancellor, by thanking you and your colleagues for the very great honour you have done me by awarding me this honorary doctorate. It has been an enormous pleasure and privilege to be associated with this wonderful, young and vibrant university as an adjunct professor over the past 15 years. It has been a particular joy to serve as the chairman of the advisory boards of the Ehrenberg Bass Institute, which under the inspiring leadership of Professor Byron Sharp and his colleagues, has established itself as the leading center for research in marketing science in the world. I'm particularly grateful for what I've just heard for the first time today of the installation of this scholarship in my name, and I must thank you all again. For me now to become even more a part of this university's community as one of its graduates is quite overwhelming. But I'm not the only one graduating today, only the oldest. If I may presume to speak on behalf of you, my younger co-graduands, I'm sure you would want me to thank the university and your teachers. I know it's a cliche, but it is nevertheless true that very many of you will look back on your time here as some of the best years of your life. But also you would want me to thank your families and friends who have stood alongside you during those years, sharing the ups and downs, encouraging you and consoling you. They too get their reward today in the pride they justifiably feel in your achievements. Now, I believe I'm expected to address a few words of wisdom to you, my fellow graduates, as you move on into what we like to call the real world. If you're anything like me, like I was at your age, your main emotion just now is largely relief that you've actually achieved what you came here to do. Some of you will be going on to further formal study, but I hope none of you think this is the end of your education. It is my strong belief that the purpose of a university education is to teach us how to learn. During my time as a university teacher, I would often meet former students who were considering changing their job, and they would ask me, when is the right time to make a move? Of course, there is no hard and fast rule. But I would always advise them to ask themselves this question: am I still learning new things? If the answer is yes, then you may want to consider staying where you are. But if the answer is no, you should certainly think about moving on. One former student said that was more useful than anything she heard from me during her degree. I think she meant it as a compliment. Others have questioned whether this is fair to employers, but I think most enlightened employers today would agree. They would expect their graduate employees to be continually adding to the sum total of knowledge in the business. If you can do that, I am sure that you will have a happy and successful career in whatever field of endeavor you choose to follow. Over the last 15 years or so that I have been visiting South Australia, I have seen tremendous changes in this university. One only has to take a short walk along North Terrace to see some of the physical changes that the university has undergone. Less easy to see are the changes in reputation and prestige that have occurred in the last 3 years alone. In the last 3 years alone, the University of South Australia has moved up 30 places in the world rankings of the new universities established in the last 50 years. Despite the fact that University of South Australia has been in existence for only 25 of those years, it is now 35th in the rankings, with most of those ahead of it being of a much older vintage. And then, just a couple of weeks ago, we learned of the magnificent achievement of the university being ranked 8th by the Australian Research Council for excellence in research. It is truly amazing that such a young university should be challenging the elite and long-established universities in Australia in such an important area as research. This is something of which you, Deputy Chancellor, and all of your colleagues can be very proud. I and my fellow graduands can also take great pride in our university and thank you and the entire staff for all that you have done for us. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Goodhart, for those very interesting remarks. I think the advice on whether you should change jobs is a message that we should all remember, and thank you for your kind words. I now invite Professor Murray Wilson, Pro Vice Chancellor of Business and Law, UniSA Business School, to begin the presentation of awards.
Deputy Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled the conditions for admission to awards of this university. I request that awards be conferred in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Wilson, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
For the degree, Doctor of Philosophy, Craig Lee, by thesis entitled Innovation, Entrepreneurship and Business Performance, a Mixed Methods Study of the Australian Restaurant Sector. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Lee. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Minh Van Pham, by thesis entitled Energy Security and the Rise of China, Toward a New Theoretical Framework for Analysis. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Pham. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Atiq Uz Zaman, by thesis entitled A Strategic Waste Management Framework and Tool for the Development of Zero Waste Cities. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Zaman. Deputy Chancellor, I present awards in the University of South Australia Business School. For the degrees of Master of Business Administration, and Master of Management, Tourism and Event Management, Chen Chiwen. For the degrees of Master of Human Resource Management and Master of Professional Accounting, Zhu Mingna. For the degrees Master of International Business and Master of Management, Integrated Supply Chain Management, Rebecca Chepkoge-Koske. For the degree of Master of International Business, Chen Jun. And Lisi Wang. For the degree of Master of International Business Extension, Harmeet Singh. For the degrees of Bachelor of Applied Finance and Bachelor of Commerce, Tan Ji Yi. For the degrees of Bachelor of Business, International Business, Finance and Trade, and Bachelor of Management Marketing, Yang Xiaolin. For the degrees of Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Management Marketing, Dai Lu. For the degree of Master of Professional Accounting, Sha Chen. Juan Fu. Chan Her. Kong Lingwen Jun. Kong Meng. Yuting Ma. Nguyen T. Tien Tan. Yanju Wang. Muya Wu. Xuan Xiao. Yu Fei. Nan Zhang. Zhu Dan Dan. Haran Zhu. and Zhang Shaolin. For the degree of Master of Professional Accounting and Finance, Bui Tan Tam. Chen Yunmeng. Chang Chen. Yishan Cheng. Kumuthu Dolawata. Yitian Gao. Thirindu Dayan Iliparuma. Kang Jen. Liu Xiaoyan. Liu Yue. Li Jin. Li Yilin. Meng Duo. Aritri Sarkar. Sha Shui. Su Lin. Wang Sui. Yun Wang. Zeng Jiechi. Ling Zhang. And Ker Zhao. For the degree of Master of Professional Accounting and Specialization, Kai Tai Cheng. Pooja Priyang Dev. Fang Le. Han Dongming. Hao Miao. Arsalan Ula Khan. Lu Xiexu. Meng Yao. Sarah Majabin. Mohammed Morshed. Nishal Shrestha. Wu Di. Jia Chong Yi. And Liang Yi Zhang. For the degrees of Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Applied Finance, Nguyen Huynh Tran Trun. For the degree of Bachelor of Applied Finance, Yuqing Bi. Bu Nan. Jansen Chia Shun Kit. Mohamed Montesia Hussein. Yu Jinan. Lan Bo. Lan Chunjie. Li Shijie. Yat Xing Li. Ali Fazi Sanaknaki. Siren Sangwan Sin. Lu Tong. Hao Yang. Hao Yang. Zheng Rui. Skip. Zhang Pujiao. Einer Sabrina Zulkifli. Chuan Zhuo. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration, Ching Chao. Chen Mei Ren. Deng Yu Jun. Deng Liu Yuan. Huang Haichun. Lei Van Min Hui. Jia Sub Li. Nguyen Minh Thong. Tai Chun To. Dao Rui. And Zhang Zhongchun. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, International Business, Finance and Trade, Chang Jia Yong. Hong Sheng Yang. Lo Zir Him. Nur Amira Shafiqa Rosni. Shakira Dinar Aifa Suleiman. And Dao Kang. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Property, Cham Ji Yi. Dom Chan Chan. Samuel Wen Jie Ho. Po Xian Li. Chin Ting Liang. And Kantawat Suenleka. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Ahmad Taufik Hidayat B. Ahmad Hassanidin. Mossad Al Masri. Amarjit Kaur. Mimi Narisa Anwar. Chen Ying. Jianing Cao. Cao Yangming. Chen Sinman. Chan Tit Ho. Chen Chi Ying. Jun Yi Chiang. Chia Pei Xiong. Yuntin Deng. Wilson Enrique Espinosa Palomino. Mohammed Zia Hul Hak Hairuddin. Shuai Hao. Yan Huang Huang. Chuk Hang Franco Ip. Jiang Kang. Y. Xiong Kui. Asif Kamal. Nurul Idra Kamarul Zaman. Farooq Ahmed Khan. Weenie Khan. Chuk Ting Ko. Peng Li. Zi Yan Li. Yi Hong Yu. Liu Pei Chen. Tran Bish Thi Li. Yan Ling Liu. Li Chuchauran. Li Yanjie. Shu Hui Lin. Liu Yao Yao. Kai Yin Lo. Lu Li He. Lu Xiao Fu. Ma Qi. Mai Truong Min An. Masuraya Manimbora. Wing Hei Mok. Mysura Manuar. Yu Kit Nian. Thibish Tramphan. Tinuak Dongfan. Yume Chi. Zhao Chin Sun. Hidehiko Seke. Xie Chuk Ling. Xi Sisi. Van T. Kim Tai. Wang Rongjiao. Wang Yao. Kwak Chun Wong. Jie Wei Wu. Chiang Yi Lin. Yu Yao Han. Qing Yin Yao. Qin Zhang. Chang Yeager. Chuo Fei Fan. Meng Fan Zhou. Zhuang Tianhui. And Hongyu Zhu. Deputy Chancellor, this concludes the first part of the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Wilson. I now invite Professor Stephen Dobson, Dean and Head of School of Education, to continue with the presentation of awards.
The degree Master of Human Resource Management Extension, Manmeet Kaur. For the degree Master of Management, Xu Xuei. For the degree of Master of Management Integrated Supply Chain Management, Peng Bao. For the degree Master of Management Strategic Procurement, Xuang Zheng. For the degree Master of Management Tourism and Event Management, Ramit Bintur-Juri. For the degree Bachelor of Management, Nguyen Ho Chi Holly Nicola. Zhuan Shi. And Wang Pianhong. For the degree Bachelor of Management Human Resource Management, Viapon Apewalui. Chen Juo. Ding Luan. Guo Juan. Huang Teng. Ka Lok Lee. Lee Metsini Z. Su Mexiao. And Wu Zeng Li. For the degree Bachelor of Management Logistics and Supply Chain Management, Alawa Maha Alawa G. Chung Hong Lam. And Tao Zhuang Jin. For the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Event Management, Vechikor Bam. Zhu Duan. Meng Yang. Zhang Zhixuan. And Zheng Yulin. For the degree of Master of Marketing, Zhang Huanlaman. For the degree of Bachelor of Management Marketing, Dajan Kui. Weiyong Chen. Wing Tu Choi. Ying Jie Lung Kong. Li Shi He. Wei Hong Jin. Lu Tao. King Zai Li. Yan Hui Lin. Lun Shulu. Tu Nyok An Nguyen. Chang Qing. Song Kai Ki. Wang Li Ting. Qin Ho Wang. And Robin Bin Ching Wong. For the degree of Bachelor of Marketing and Communication, Vindo Mahoron. Deputy Chancellor, I present awards in the Division of Education, Art and Social Sciences. For the degree Master of Master of Architecture, Chun Kit Chui. Suk Yuan Chong. Pok Fong Alexander Lau. Pak Mei Mei. Kui Yu Yua. Shir Yi Sum. Hu Nen Vu. Wang Bing Yang. Kang Wo Keat. Chek Hei Wong. Wu Yi. Yan Chik Pong. And Cho Jezi. For the degree of Master of Visual Art and Design Graphic Design, Wachacha Sun Ton Saro Tun. For the degree of Bachelor of Architectural Studies, Sharita Vada Yamma Lalasari. Chung Ming Cham. Man Hong Chuang. Chua Chua Chung. Ken Pang Lim. Nguyen Hinrich. Lok Si Wa. Wong Fuk Tong. And Jiang Hansi. For the degree Bachelor of Design, Product Design, Chen Chang Zi. Chung Li Zhang. Jen Kiwin. And Zhou Xing. For the degree of Bachelor of Design Visual Communication, Pam Ti Tam Tam. For the degree of Bachelor of Visual Arts, Jewellery and Metal, Gu Chen Jing. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Communication and Media Management, Ho Wat Rita Chi. Chi Ching Hong. Wing Yan Leon. Xin Jiet Lim. Siti Mahi Razilanam Azam. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Languages and Intercultural Communication, Boonzi Lo. Sarah Shafira Maud Hassan. And Kay Mahashita. For the degree of Bachelor of International Relations, Anna Christina Bagquist. Hok Chun John Ma. And Azrul Arif Mod Aliyez. For the degree of Bachelor of Media Arts, Kao Lu. Cho Ki Choli Cheng. And Cheng Hua Chi. For the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations, Kate J. Lin. For the degree of Master of Teaching Early Childhood, Xian Qing Duan. Wen Ting Hao. Yir Li. Xiang Nin Li. Mota Wamu Ngumo. DMT Nyok Nguyen. Yiming Nui. Sakun. Cherry Melin Sinclair. Bishuang Teng. Juliana Marcella Velez Diaz. Wong Gineng. Xu Ran. Shui Yang. Yu Tian Nui. Yi Zhao. And Xian Yang. For the degree of Master of Teaching Secondary, Harajinder Kaur Dutt. Li Tong Tong. Li Tom Ti. Byung Song. Wong Rojuin. For the degree Bachelor of Early Bachelor of Education Early Childhood, Wao Hyo Yong. For the degree of Bachelor of Education Primary, Xinyang Anna Pok. Larissa Annette Swanbeck. For the degree of Master of Social Work, Yuan Tao So. Chu Wei Wei. Paul Wambugi Irunugu.
Wafa Jaber. Ladli Koti Purata Sasid Haram. On Keely. Jiggy Manya Cherry Baby. Peris Jelagat Miso. Nguyen Thi An. Miri Palaparambil Anthony. Panshur T.C. Way. Niraji Taki D. Kali, Naraji Nen. Tinsy Thomas. Sodi T. Luvan K. Mat. Vukaji Belina. Wo Wang Si. And Wen Jan. For the degree of Bachelor of Psychological Science, Chan Quan Nam. Chen Yang. Chandini Do Krishna Nariya. Chung Ho Lim. Leonard Sakwai Hong. And Amanda Sin GT. Deputy Chancellor, I present an award in the Division of Health Sciences for the degree of Bachelor of Nursing, Kuan Yin Lin. Deputy Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Dobson. I'm sure that everyone here today shares a sense of success of our graduates and the pride of their families and friends in this significant achievement in their academic and professional careers. Graduates, You have shared one of the most significant periods of your life with your colleagues at the University of South Australia. You have just graduated from one of the world's youngest and best universities. As you've heard already today, we're not only considered in the top 35 of the world's best young universities by Times Higher Education rankings, but the QS rankings put us in the world's top 25. And last week, your degree became even more valuable when we were named one of Australia's top 8 research universities. We're young and we're smart and we're enterprising, and so are you. And you're about to share your skills with the world, but I hope you continue to choose to your association with us, choose to continue your association with us. You can do this through the Alumni Network, which offers you some wonderful benefits along with the opportunity for ongoing contact with your colleagues and continued participation in the life and success of your university. And now I would like the graduates to remain seated while the rest of us in this assembly stand to congratulate them in the usual manner.